first we see mass percentage, second we see normal. And third is the normality. Normality defined as the number of gram, is defined as the number of gram equivalent of solute. Number of gram equivalent of solute dissolved in 1 liter of solution. Dissolved in 1 liter of solution are known as normal. It is defined as the number of gram equivalent of solute dissolved in 1 liter of solution. Denoted by N. So normality equals to mass of solute into 1000 upon equivalent mass of solute into volume of solution in milliliter. So many times defined it is, in short it is simply gram equivalent of solute, gram equivalent of solute upon volume of solution in liter. Right? So it is defined as and short mass of solute denoted by WP into 1000 upon equivalent weight into volume. It is called normality, number of gram equivalent of solute dissolved in 1 liter of solution. If 1 gram equivalent of solute dissolved in 1 liter of the solution, the resulting solution we call normal solution. Such type of solution we call normal solution. If 1 gram equivalent of solute dissolved in 1 liter of a solution. Second, after this normality, next one is the molality. Next one is molality.
Present in
solute, gram moles of solute upon mass of solvent in kilogram. Mass of solvent in kilogram. And similarly in gram mass they were in questions. So mass of solute, mass of solute into percent upon molecular mass of solute into mass of solute in gram. Here mass of solute in gram. That is mass of solute into percent upon molecular mass into mass of solvent in gram are called molality of solution. That is fourth terms we use to express the concentration molality. And if 1 mole of solute present in 1 kilogram of solvent, 1 mole of solute present in 1 kilogram of solvent, so resulting solution we call 1 molar solution. It is known as the molar solution. After molality, the next is mole fraction. The next is the mole fraction. Mole fraction is defined as the ratio of the number of moles of one component, solute or solvent, to the total number of moles present in the solution. It is defined as the ratio of the number of moles of one component, maybe solute or solvent, to the total number of moles of solution, means solute plus solvent. It is denoted by H. So mole fraction is the ratio of number of moles of solute. It is the ratio of number of moles of solute or solvent upon total number of moles of solution. Total number of moles of solution. And solution contains solute and solvent. That means so number of moles of solute plus number of moles of solvent. It is denoted by X. So mole fractions of solute equals to number of moles of solute upon total number of moles solute and solvent. Similarly, number of moles, mole fraction of solvent is the number of moles of solvent upon total number of moles. It is mole fraction, ratio of the number of moles of one component upon the total number of moles. And we know that number of moles we calculated by the given mass upon molecular mass. So further we increases number of moles of solute, we can calculate mass of solute upon molecular mass upon mass of solvent, molecular mass, mass of solute upon molecular mass. Further we increases, we calculate the number of moles. Similarly, solvent, WM1, MA, then WA, MA, plus WB, MA. And one more, the mole fraction of solute plus solvent is always equals to 1. The mole fraction of solute and solvent equals to 1. So it is the next mole fractions. It is defined as the ratio of the number of moles of one component, solute or solvent, to the total number of moles of solution, that is solute plus solvent, denoted by X. And the mole fraction of solute and solvent always equals to